So let's first talk about the practical implications of running as an independent. I saw a poll where you actually are starting to register some numbers, but I want to know, what is the point? I mean, you've run before. Is this about sending a message? Is this about actually winning? And what do you say to folks that say, hey, you could, if you get 7 to 10% of the vote, you can end up being the reason that Menendez gets reelected?
Those are great questions, Bill, and let me take them one by one. When I first entered this race, I told the Libertarian Party membership that I was interested in running a competitive campaign. That means raising enough money to get our message out, getting on media like your show, and giving people the opportunity to say, hey, Republicans and Democrats have ruled America for 160 years, and no one's happy with the state of the country. So something is wrong if Republicans and Democrats have been in charge, and I'm offering an alternative to take care of the deficit problem, the military intervention all over the world to protect our civil liberties, especially our Second Amendment rights, our First Amendment rights. And now the fact that the mainstream media have totally blocked my campaign. They haven't given me any coverage in the mainstream press. So we commissioned a poll to see where we stood, and we showed it 16%, which is extraordinary. If anyone would have said in March when I got the nomination that I would be at 16% in August, people would say, you're crazy.
Mm-hmm.
And this is with a total blackout. Listen, when the reporters discuss the campaign, they're talking about Menendez and Ugin, which means they're getting free coverage, which is worth a lot of money to their campaigns because they're getting the people to focus in on them. It's time for the media to focus on my campaign because I've been all over the state, Bill, and my message is resonating. The universal credits for charitable donations, which would be a big boon to the people of New Jersey. I'm going to roll out tonight at the Long Hills Tea Party at 6 o'clock in Gillette my tax proposals, which will make the economy the best in the world, build upon what the Trump administration has done.
I was going to ask you two questions. One, where do you stand on the Trump tax cuts, which I have pointed out you could, you know, any number of even plus or minus 5 or 6 points, 3 out of 4 New Jerseyans will benefit in some way.
Well, I'm always in favor of tax cuts, but you know, I wrote the book on how to have a tax-free America from the mid-1990s, and that's the blueprint that we should follow, how to reduce the size and scope of government so people in New Jersey and around the country take the money that they earn and take care of their families, take care of people in their communities through the nonprofit sector. I'm the only one that's talking about this, of real solutions that will impact people's lives positively. The two other candidates are just tearing each other apart with negative ads. I'm offering solutions for the issues that are facing the people of New Jersey and the people of America. I'm always in favor of tax cuts. The problem with the Trump tax cuts is there were no spending cuts, and the deficit is exploding in good economic times. This is a prescription for a terrible financial crisis down the road. In addition, we have had the Federal Reserve flooding the economy with trillions and trillions of dollars of money, and we know that happened before the housing bubble, that happened before the dot-com bubble. So this ends very badly because of the perfect storm of increasing deficits and cheap money, which is raising values. And
real quick.
It's unsustainable.
Murray, we've got about 30 seconds, but I want to ask you, how about this latest deal President announced yesterday, trade deal with Mexico, could be huge for American workers, huge for American manufacturing. Does this play into your plan of a tax-free America, given that we're putting some of the weight now on tariffs?
Well, anything that reduces trade barriers are good for people all over the world because free flow of goods means that people will have to be productive. They'll have to use the resources that they have in their economy in order to satisfy the needs of people. That's what a free market economy is all about. I've been promoting this for 50 years. Free trade in the country, free trade among peoples of the world will be the best anti-poverty program and raise living standards all over the world.